Good morning, all of you. I am Dr. Abhay Deshpande, Associate Professor, RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. And today, I'm starting with unit number 5, that is time-varying fields. So this is my 6th lecture. And today's outline is, I'm going to cover today, that is Faraday's law. And second one is displacement current. So let me start with the first one, that is Faraday's law. Now, based on the previous study, we can define the Faraday's law as E is equal to minus N into d phi by dt volts, wherein which capital N represents the number of turns in the circuit and E represents the induced EMF and the phi represents the flux. The induced flux is represented by phi, and according to Faraday's law, the induced EMF E is equal to minus N into d phi by dt volt. Now, in this equation, now let us assume there is a single turn circuit, that means capital N is equal to 1. So if capital N is equal to 1, the Faraday's law can be stated as E is equal to minus d phi divided by dt volts, that is capital N is equal to 1. So I have defined the Faraday's law for capital N equal to 1. Now, next one. Now again, from the previous study, we can define an induced EMF as E is equal to a closed path integration E dot dl. So we have defined this induced EMF in our previous study. And in this, the magnetic flux phi passing through a specified area, it is given by phi is equal to an integration of B dot ds, where B is the magnetic flux density over a surface area ds. So this equation is EMF induced. Even we have seen this E dot dl in case of Stokes theorem, that is E is equal to for a closed path integration of E dot dl. Now for a magnetic flux phi is equal to a surface integration of B dot ds. Now in this equation, B is a magnetic flux density. Now let us substitute this equation, that is phi is equal to b dot ds, in the equation of EMF, that is Faraday's law, that is E is equal to minus d phi by dt. So in this, I will substitute the value of phi as integration over a surface b dot ds. Now, can I equate these two induced EMF equation, and that can be written as the induced EMF E is equal to the integration for a closed path E dot dl, that is line integration, that is equal to minus d by dt of B dot ds over a surface. So this is the equation, that is induced EMF I have written. Now, E dot dl can be is equal to minus, so this dou by dou t, that is I will take it inside and I will write it as d by dt, I will take it inside and I will write it as dou by dou t of b dot ds, that is dou v by dou t dot ds minus. Now E dot dl in the line integration can be written in terms of surface integration also using a Stokes theorem. So E dot dl, I will write it as del cross E dot ds, that is in the surface. The line integration, I have changed it to surface integration using a Stokes theorem, that is E dot dl. Now I will write it as del cross E dot ds, that is equal to minus dou v by dou t dot ds over a surface integration, that is as it is, that is the right side. Now, if I compare these two equations, both are surface. So is not from this. I can write it as del cross E dot ds is equal to minus dou B by dou T dot ds. Hence, del cross E is equal to minus dou B divided by dou T. So from this equation, I can write del cross E as minus dou B divided by dou T. So this del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T. This is one of the Maxwell's equation in time varying field. We will call it as a time varying field because the magnetic flux density B, it is totally depend on the time, that is dou by dt of B. So since it is varying with respect to time, we will call it as time varying field. And this we have achieved using Faraday's law. So initially, in case of electrostatics, we have defined del cross E is equal to zero. But if I take a time varying field, then del cross E will become minus dou B divided by dou T. So still, a del cross E is equal to zero, I will write it for a static field, and del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T, I will write it for time varying field. So this is one of the Maxwell's equation. What is the correction we have done in case of time varying field? Next. Now let us define in terms of force, that is the force on a charge Q moving at a velocity V in a magnetic field B. It is given by F is equal to Q into V cross B. This also we have done in magnetic forces. Now F divided by Q. I will rearrange this equation as F divided by Q is equal to V cross B. Now we know that F divided by Q is nothing but the field intensity, capital E. So capital E is nothing but F divided by Q, that is force divided by charge. Hence, the induced EMF, it is given by EM dot DL, that is EM E dot DL, I will write E dot DL, that is EM dot DL, induced EMF is equal to, now what is there in the right side? V cross V. So a line integral of EM dot DL is equal to, for a closed path, integral V cross B dot DL, for a small differential length DL, we have to integrate. So this is also the equation, induced EMF equation, using the equation of force on a charge Q moving at a velocity V. Now from this, we can define two EMFs. One is transformer EMF, another one is generator EMF. So the transformer EMF is one which we have already derived, that is del minus dou B by dou T. So minus dou B by dou T dot ds is one equation because EM dot DL, E dot DL is equal to minus surface integration of dou B by dou T dot ds. This is one EMF, and this EMF we will call it as transformer EMF. And one more EMF is E dot DL over a closed path integral is equal to integration of V cross B dot DL. So this EMF we will call it as generator EMF. So if I want to calculate the total EMF, then the total induced EMF is a combination of transformer EMF and generator EMF. So this is how we will define the induced EMF, and one of the Maxwell's equation in time varying field is del cross E is equal to minus dou B divided by dou T. So based on this concept on the Faraday's law, let us solve some simple examples. Let us take the first example, that is a conductor 1 centimeter in length is parallel to Z axis and rotates at radius of 25 centimeter at 1200 rpm, full stop. Find induced voltage if the radial field is given by B is equal to 0.5 in AR direction, Tesla. So it is in AR direction, 0.5 Tesla. Conductor is 1 centimeter length. It rotates at a radius of 25 centimeter and it is parallel to Z axis. And now we need to calculate the induced voltage. Now let us calculate the field intensity E is equal to V cross B. From the study of Faraday's law, E is equal to V cross B, where V is the velocity, that is linear velocity. And let us calculate V first. Now V is equal to 4 pi R in A phi direction, then 4 pi R value, the radius is 25 centimeter. That is 25 into 10 to the power minus 2 in A phi direction. Then simplify this. That is 4 pi into 25 into 10 to the power minus 2. Simplify this and put it in meter per second. So this becomes V is equal to 31.416 in A phi direction. Meter per second. So this is how I have calculated the linear velocity V, because to calculate field intensity E is nothing but V cross B. I need both V and B. So B they have given as 0.5 AR. Hence I have calculated the linear velocity V. Now I will calculate the field intensity E is equal to V cross B. V value is 31.416 A phi and B value is 0.5 AR. 31.416 A phi and B value is 0.5 AR. A phi cross AR. I will get minus AZ and the value is 15.708. AZ minus AZ, that is my field intensity E. But in this question I need to calculate the induced voltage. Hence induced voltage can be defined as E is equal to integration of E dot dl. For a closed path line integration, single integration of E dot dl. So I have calculated the value of E. Now I need to calculate DL. Now in the question they have given the conductor is parallel to Z axis. Hence DL is equal to DZ into AZ, since it is parallel to Z axis. Then the induced EMF E is equal to integration of 0 to 0.01, because the length is 1 centimeter. Hence I will integrate it from Z is equal to 0 to 0.01. It is parallel to Z axis. E dot dl. E value is 15.708. And dl value is dz, az. Now I will write minus sign as it is. Integration of dz is z from 0 to 0.01. Then I will get 0.01 into 15.708 into minus 1. I will get it as induced EMF E is equal to minus 157.08 millivolt. So the induced voltage E is equal to minus 157.08. millivolt is the answer. Now let us take one more example. That is an area of 0.65 meter square in the plane z is equal to 0 encloses a filamentary conductor. Then find the induced voltage if B is equal to 0.05 cos 10 to the power 3 t Ay plus Az divided by root 2 Tesla. So in this question also, I need to calculate the induced voltage. Now, the difference between the previous question and this question is, in this question, the flux density B is in time varying. That means it is a function of a T. But where in which, in the previous question, B is not at all a function of a T. That means it was not in time varying field. But in this question, the B is in time varying field. Hence, if I want to calculate the induced voltage in time varying field, then definitely I need to use Faraday's law. And according to law, the induced EMF E is equal to minus integration of dou V by dou T dot ds over a surface S. This is the equation to calculate the induced EMF E in case of time varying field. And I know the value of V, it is given in the numerical. Then the left out is ds. Ds is the filamentary conductor is fixed and it is placed in z is equal to 0 plane and it encloses area of 0.65 meter square. Since it is placed in z is equal to 0 plane, then the area ds is equal to ds into az because it is placed in z is equal to 0. Then substitute the value of B as well as the ds. So in the integration surface, dou B by dou T dot ds, B value, substitute this B value, that is 0.05 cos 10 to the power 3 T Ay plus Az divided by root 2 dou by dou T of this value dot ds is. Now try to simplify this. That is dou by dou T of this term. I have cos 10 to the power 3 T. So I will get it as 10 to the power 3 into minus sine 10 to the power 3 T. Derivative of cos is minus sine into 10 to the power 3 because it is coefficient of T sine 10 to the power 3 T. Divided by root 2 as it is and ds as it is, then I have ay dot az and az dot az. Hence I will get it, only az dot az will survive and I will write that as ds. Now I will take this constant term along with sine 10 to the power 3 t outside of the integration and I will simplify this term, that is 0.05 into 10 to the power 3 divided by root 2. I will simplify this along with this minus. I will get it as a plus 35.355 sine 10 to the power 3 t and the integration is for ds, the surface integration, that is area for ds, and in the numerical they have given the area is equal to 0.65 meter square. This is the area, 0.65 meter square. Hence, the entire integration along with the ds can be written as 0.65 meter square. So, the induced EMF E is equal to 35.355 sine 10 to the power 3 t into 0.65. So, multiply this, then E is equal to 22.98 sine 10 to the power 3 t volts is nothing but the induced EMF in time varying field. So, we have done a numerical in time varying field also, how to calculate the induced voltage. So, I have calculated induced voltage E, that is induced EMF, both are same. Now, next concept is displacement current. Now, in case of Faraday's law, we had del cross E is equal to zero, and in time varying field, we have given the correction as del cross E is equal to minus dou B divided by dou T, because the flux density is varying with respect to time period. Now, in this concept, that is displacement current, we are changing the Ampere's circuital law in time varying field. That is, the point form of Ampere's circuital law is given by del cross H is equal to J. This is the formula which we have already derived. That is, del cross H is equal to J, and it is called as Ampere's circuital law. Now, let us take a divergence on both sides. So, taking divergence on both sides, I will get del dot of del cross H is equal to del dot J. Now, since it is del dot J and del dot of del cross H, then this will be equated to zero based on the basic laws. Del dot J is equal to zero. Then, from the equation of continuity, we know that del dot J is equal to minus dou rho V by dou T, where rho V is volume charge density, minus dou rho V divided by dou T is nothing but del dot J, where J is the current density. So, when del dot J is existing, it has some value, that is minus dou rho V by dou T in volume, means the equation number 1, Ampere circuital law, instead of writing del cross H equal to J, definitely there will be some term which is adding to this J because of this concept, equation of continuity. Hence, we will rewrite the Ampere circuital law as del cross H is equal to J plus some term capital N. So, it is an unknown term capital N we have added because del dot J is not equal to 0. It is giving me some value based on the equation of continuity as minus dou rho V divided by dou T. Hence, Ampere circuital law can be redefined as del cross H is equal to J plus capital N, where N is the unknown term. Now, my aim is to calculate what is the value of N so that del cross H is equal to J plus, I can substitute the term, the value of capital N. So, the next steps are to calculate what is the unknown value, that is capital N. So, from the del cross H, from the previous equation, we can write it as, if you take the divergence, we can write this as del dot of del cross H is equal to del dot of J plus N, that is nothing but del dot J plus del dot N which is equal to 0, because del dot of del cross H is equal to 0. Now, from the equation of continuity, we know that del dot J is equal to minus dou rho V divided by dou T. Now, if this equation to be holds good, then the value of del dot N should be is equal to dou rho V by dou T, because del dot J is minus dou rho V by dou T. Hence, del dot N should be dou rho V by dou T. Now again, we will use a Gauss law. From the equation of Gauss law, del dot D is equal to rho V, that is volume charge density rho V is equal to del dot D. Hence, we will replace the value of rho V in the equation of del dot N. Then del dot N is equal to dou by dou T of rho V. Rho V, I will replace it as del dot D. Gauss law, we have done in electrostatics. Del dot D is equal to rho V. Hence, I have substituted the value of rho V in this equation, and I will get it as dou by dou T of del dot D. Now, dou by dou T is related to the term D. Hence, I will take the del outside. I will write it as del dot of dou D by dou T, and left side it is del dot of N as it is. So, del dot of N, dou rho V by dou T, I will replace rho V as del dot D. Hence, del dot N is equal to del dot of dou D divided by dou T. Now, is not comparing this equation, that is del dot N is equal to del dot dou D by dou T. I can write N is equal to dou D by dou T. So, the unknown term N value is equal to dou D divided by dou T. Now, the Ampere's circuital law in point form, what we have defined, that is del cross H is equal to J. Now, del cross H is equal to not simply J, it is J plus dou D divided by dou T, because it is in time varying field. The value of D is varying with respect to time period. So, in case of electric field, capital E is electric field and D is the flux. That is electric density, dou D by dou T. Hence, the Ampere circuital law in point form can be written as del cross H is equal to JC plus dou D divided by dou T, or else we can write it as del cross H is equal to JC plus JD. J plus dou D by dou T, we will write it as JC plus JD, where JC is the conduction current density and JD is the displacement current density. So, I have two current densities now in Ampere circuital law. One is conduction current and one more term I will call it as displacement current, where JC, we know JC is equal to sigma E, field intensity, and now we can define JD is equal to dou D divided by dou T. So, we can define the ratio of JC by JD, that is conduction current density divided by displacement current density, as sigma divided by omega E, where we know sigma is conductivity, omega is the angular frequency, and epsilon value, we know epsilon is equal to epsilon naught into epsilon r. So, in this case, sigma divided by omega E, if it is greater than 1, then the given medium is conductor, and if it is less than 1, then the given medium is dielectric. But in the lossy medium, for a lossy medium, JC divided by JD is equal to always sigma divided by omega times E, where JC is conduction current density and JD is the displacement current density. Now let us define what is a displacement current, the equation of displacement current ID. Now the total displacement current crossing any given surface is expressed by the surface integral, that is ID is equal to surface integration of JD dot DS. Now we know that I is equal to J dot DS. Now in this case, I is replaced by ID and J should be replaced by JD, which stands for displacement current. So that is equal to integration surface. What is the value of JD? It is dou D divided by dou T dot DS. So this is how we will define the displacement current. And we know capital D is equal to epsilon times E, but we know that field intensity E can be written as V divided by D. Hence, we will write this as epsilon is epsilon times V naught divided by D, and let us write V naught as V naught cos omega T. Then ID is equal to dou D by dou T S, that is dou D by dou T of S. So I have epsilon, S and D as a constant. Then derivative of cos omega T is minus sin omega T into omega. So I will write this as my displacement current. Now in time varying version of Ampere circuit law, earlier we used to define Ampere circuit law as del cross H, but now del cross H is redefined as del cross H is equal to J plus dou D by dou T. Earlier it was only del cross H is equal to J, but now it is replaced as del cross H is equal to J plus dou D by dou T. Hence, a time varying field version of Ampere circuit law is del cross H over a surface DS is equal to integration of J dot DS plus integration of dou D by dou T dot DS. So this is an extra term which we have derived in time varying field. Hence, Stokes theorem, that is for a closed path, H dot DL is equal to I earlier, but now it is I plus ID, where ID is the displacement current. So I will write this as I plus ID value is dou D divided by dou T dot DS over a surface S. So this is how there is a correction for the Ampere circuit law, and this is also called as one of the Maxwell's equation, that is del cross H is equal to J plus dou D by dou T in time varying field. Now let us do some simple numerical, simple examples based on the displacement current. That is, in a given lossy dielectric medium, conduction current density JC is equal to 0.02 sin 10 to the power 90 ampere per meter square from JC. We need to calculate, find the displacement current density if sigma is equal to 10 to the power 3, epsilon r is equal to 6.5. So they have given conduction current density and asking to calculate the displacement current density. And we know that for a lossy dielectric medium, JC divided by JD is equal to sigma divided by omega E. So we know that JC by JD is equal to sigma divided by omega epsilon. Now we will rearrange this. That is, I need displacement current JD. Hence, JD is equal to JC into omega epsilon divided by sigma. Now let us substitute all the values. Omega value from this, omega value is 10 to the power 9 in the given equation. Sin omega t for omega value is 10 to the power 9. Epsilon value is epsilon naught into epsilon r. Into JC value, the JC value is 0.02. Now substitute JD is equal to 10 to the power 9 into epsilon r. Epsilon r value they have given as 6.5 in the numerical. Then epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12. And JC value is 0.02 as it is divided by 10 to the power 3. That is sigma value. Now calculate the value of JD. We will get JD value is equal to 1.151 into 10 to the power minus 6 ampere per meter square, and we will write it as 1.151 micro ampere per meter square. Now we can define that JD and JC, that is displacement current and the conduction current, both should be always right angles to each other. That means if JC is represented in terms of sine omega t, we will represent JD in terms of cos omega t as 1.151 cos 10 to the power 90 micro ampere per meter square is the displacement current for the given conduction current density. So this is how we will do the numerical on a conduction current as well as a displacement current. Now let us take one more example to calculate the displacement current. This numerical is, that is, find the displacement current density within a parallel plate capacitor having a dielectric with epsilon r is equal to 10, area of plates capital A is equal to 0.01 meter square, distance of separation d is equal to 0.05 millimeter, and the applied voltage is V is equal to 200 sine 200 t. So I need to calculate the displacement current density, that is JD, and they have given the value of V, that is the voltage. Now we know that current through the parallel plate capacitor in time varying field, that is the applied voltage is in time varying field, is given by current IC is equal to epsilon A divided by D, dv divided by dt, that is conduction current. For a parallel plate capacitor, the current through it is given by IC is equal to epsilon A divided by D, dv divided by dt. Now let us substitute all the values. Epsilon value is epsilon naught into epsilon r, A divided by D into dv by dt. Now substitute all the values, that is IC is equal to epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, epsilon r is 10, then area A is equal to 0.01 meter square, substitute it as 0.01, whole divided by D, D value is, separation is 0.05 millimeter. Hence, I will write 0.05 into 10 to the power minus 3. And dv by dt. So dv by dt can be written as d by dt of v, and v value they have given in the numerical as 200 sine 200 t. Now let us simplify. That is the displacement current IC. That is d by dt of 200 sine 200 t. Derivative of sine 200 t is cos 200 t into 200. Along with this 200, you multiply with this term and write it as cos 200 t into, after simplifying all these values, we will get it as 0.7083 into 10 to the power minus 3 ampere. The conduction current IC after the calculation can be written as 0.7083 into 10 to the power minus 3 cos 200 t ampere, because the derivative of sine is cos. Now we know that for a parallel plate capacitor, if I take a parallel plate, then both conduction current is equal to displacement current. Hence, the displacement current is given by current divided by area, and the displacement current is equal to conduction current in parallel plate, and we have already calculated the value of IC, which is equal to ID divided by area E. So ID value is 0.7083 into 10 to the power minus 3 cos 200 t, and area is 0.01 meter square. So this divided by 0.01, and calculate the value of displacement current density, and we will get it as 70.832 into 10 to the power minus 3 cos 200 t ampere per meter square. The displacement current we will get it as 70.832 into 10 to the power minus 3 cos 200 t ampere per meter square. Let us take one more example. A two-dimensional electric field is given by E is equal to x square ax plus x ay volt per meter. Full stop. Show that this electric field cannot arise from a static distribution of charges. So they have given capital E. And we need to show that this E is not arising because of static distribution of charges. So how to show that? So for a static distribution of charges, for the given E, the Maxwell equation is given by del cross E should be equal to 0. For the given E in static distribution, del cross E is equal to 0. Now for this E, let us calculate what is the value of del cross E. Now del cross E, del cross of E value is x square ax plus x ay. Substitute x square is ax plus x ay. So I need to calculate the cross product, del cross ax ay az. Dou by dou x, dou by dou y, dou by dou z, and ax component is x square, ay component is x, and az component is 0. Let us calculate the cross product. then ax as it is dou by dou x of ax as it is, this column we have to leave. Then dou by dou y of 0 minus dou by dou z of x, ax component minus ay component, a minus ay into dou by dou x of 0 minus dou by dou z of x square, and the last component az is equal to plus az into dou by dou x of x minus dou by dou y of x square. Now from this, if you see the first term, dou by dou y of 0, dou by dou z of x, dou by dou x of 0, dou by dou z of x square, everything will be 0. And in the last term, dou by dou x of x is equal to 1, and dou by dou y of x square is also 0. So dou by dou x of x is equal to 1 into az. So the answer is 1 into az. So this is nothing but del cross E answer. So what is the answer of del cross E now? Az. But according to Maxwell's equation in static distribution of charge, del cross E should be is equal to 0. But in this question, del cross E is not becoming equal to 0. Instead, it is having some value as Az. Hence, we can say that the given electric field, it cannot arise from a static distribution of charges. It is not arising because of static distribution of charges. This is the Maxwell's equation. So if it is not a static distribution, if it is in a time varying field, then what is the change we have done for del cross E? That is, del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T using the concept of Faraday's law. But in this case, Maxwell's equation is del cross E equal to 0, which the given E is not satisfying. Hence, the given E is not arising because of static distribution. So based on this concept, we will have some quiz questions. Let us take the first one. First quiz question. Equation of continuity for time varying field. What is the equation of continuity for time varying field? Is it del dot J is equal to minus dou rho V by dou T? Or is it del cross E is equal to minus dou V by dou T? Yes. Option is, answer is option A. First option, equation of continuity is minus dou rho V divided by dou T. Let us take second one. Now, Ampere circuital law for time varying field. What is Ampere circuital law for time varying field? Is it del cross H equal to J? Or is it del cross H equal to J plus dou D by dou T? Or is it del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T? Ampere circuital law for time varying field. Yes, answer is option B, that is del cross H is equal to J plus dou D divided by dou T. So this is the content what I want to deal today. That is, we have done a Faraday's law and the correction to the Maxwell's equation. What is Maxwell's equation was del cross E equal to 0, and in time varying field it is del cross E is equal to minus dou B by dou T. And second concept we have done is the displacement current, and in that, for the Ampere's law, del cross H is equal to 0, J, del cross H is equal to J. But in time varying field, there is a correction as del cross H is equal to J plus dou D divided by dou T. This is the correction we have done for the Maxwell's equation. And this is the concept which I want to teach you today. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot.